with me. Yeah. Know how he tells me that I am his own.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, brothers and sisters. Welcome to another episode of God's Glory and His Story. I'm your host, MC Enemy. But it's not about me. It's about the Word of God and His truth on this channel. You know my name, Lord. Thank you for calling me into your marvelous light. And I pray that this episode and this channel will do the same for you, calling you into His marvelous light. Welcome to Sabbath, True Sabbath Fellowship, brothers and sisters. This episode will be originally aired on Thursday, December 2nd, 2021. It is 28 days after the new moon. Watch your calendar because it's about to shift. New moon's coming up this Saturday, so the next Sabbath will be on the 11th of December will be the next Sabbath. That will be the next episode, if God's willing. On this channel, it's the history that you need because Yesiah did bleed. All the rest will come when he comes on his steed. Don't forget the prayer of Paul to the Ephesians, Ephesians chapter 3, verse 16 through 21. If you read it, it will bless you with understanding of God's word and his love for you. If you haven't done so yet or you are new to this channel, we ask that you please download at least 2 Bible apps. And we ask that you make one of those Bible apps the 1611 King James Bible with the Apocrypha. Reason for it, right in the middle of your screen, the facts of every case must be established by the testimony of 2 or 3 witnesses. And that 1611 King James Bible with the Apocrypha has additional books in there that will edify you. So make sure you have that one. You won't find those books in some of the other standard versions. All right, today's episode is 8 overlooked signs of the end times. Let's get to work, brothers and sisters. Oh, it's going to be a good one, especially at number 7. Stay tuned. So we're going to look at signs in the heavens. The whole world is silent. The return of a pure tongue. We're going to look at role reversal. We're going to look at the fact time is speeding up. We're going to look at the rise of lawlessness. The setup of one religion. And true Israel's blindness ending. Let's get to work. Number 1, we're looking at signs in the heavens. Of course, we're going to be doing this with scripture throughout. So New Living Translation, Luke chapter 21, verse 25, it is written, and there will be strange signs in the sun, moon, and stars. Here on earth, the nations will be in turmoil, perplexed by the roaring seas and strange tides. So on the left of your screen, you see a typical half moon. That's what you normally see. The half moons, either the left side or the right side. That was what you would normally see. Well, I happened to notice in the stars the other day, on the day that most of us were eating turkey, on that same day, which happened to have been a Sabbath also, the half moon was the bottom half of the moon, as you see on the right. Now, I don't know if that's a common thing, but it just stood out to me that that's not a normal half moon. But that's not all. Look at space.com. We had a full beaver moon of November 2021 that just passed through the Earth's shadow in a partial lunar eclipse overnight on November 18th and 19th. And here's the key. It was in what was the longest eclipse of its kind in 580 years. I'd call that a sign of wonder in the stars, moons in the stars, right? Sun in the stars. If you go back to episode 61, you're going to learn more about Remphan or the star of Remphan. So I'm just going to read part of this excerpt. It's from Revelation 8, verse 10 and 11. It is written, and the third angel sounded, and there fell a great star from heaven, burning as if it were a lamp, and it fell upon a third of the river, upon the fountains of waters. And the name of the star is called Wormwood. And the third part of the waters became wormwood. And many men died of the waters because they were made bitter. And then in a writing from the article, it says, all demons were expelled from heaven, were deglorified, and Remphan received a so bitter coating that contaminated the waters, which is why Apostle John, who is the writer of Revelation, described this star as wormwood. So there's the star of Remphan, 6 points, 6 triangles, 6 sides. And if that doesn't remind you of someone's flag, go back and look at episode 61 and get more context on it. Number 2, the whole world is silent. New Living Translation, Habakkuk chapter 2, verse 3 and verse 20. It is written, this vision is for a future time. It describes the end, and it will be fulfilled. If it seems slow in coming, wait patiently, for it will surely take place. It will not be delayed. So I just put that in there so that you can see that this is an end time prophecy. Now jump down to verse 20, and it reads, But the Lord is in his holy temple. Let all the earth be silent before him. Here's a picture of Times Square in New York City during the 2020 lockdowns. That looks like the whole earth was silent to me. I know it's just one city, but that same image was around the entire earth. The whole earth was silent before him. Is the king prepping or preparing for his return? New Living Translation, Zephaniah chapter 1, verses 7 and 8. It is written, stand in silence in the presence of the sovereign Lord, for the awesome day of the Lord's judgment is near. The Lord has prepared his people for a great slaughter and has chosen their executioners. On that day of judgment, says the Lord, I will punish the leaders and princes of Judah and all those following pagan customs. Number three, the return of a pure tongue. 1611 King James Bible, Zephaniah chapter 3, verse 9, it is written, for then I will turn to the people a pure language, that they may call upon the name of the Lord to serve him with one consent. So biblical Hebrew, which is listed here in the different dialects of Hebrew, biblical Hebrew is actually Paleo Hebrew. That's one of the dialects of the Hebrew language. So it's Paleo Hebrew. So God has many names. We know that. However, there is only one name that he first revealed to Moses. He told him in English, I am that I am. So we Googled I am. And it says that the original Hebrew, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob spoke, that corresponds with I am that I am, is Ahaya, Asha, Ahaya. And that is Paleo Hebrew. So it simply means I am that I am. Now, we have to remember that the one we call Jesus, the son of Ahaya, came in his father's name. 1611 King James Bible, Philippians chapter 2, verses 9 through 11, it is written, wherefore God also hath highly exalted him and given him a name which is above every name. That at the name of, it says Jesus, every knee should bow of things in heaven and things in earth and things under the earth, and that every tongue should confess that, it says Jesus Christ, is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. So the name Jesus definitely works. I just want to make that clear, because he knows who you're calling. You're calling him and you're worshiping him in spirit and in truth. He knows. So the name Jesus definitely does work. However, there are other people that use that name. A lot of people walk around with the name Jesus in the Latin world. So thereby making it not a name above all names, as the scripture says. And I'm not trying to diminish it. So I don't want everybody writing me with angry, you know, notes and stuff or whatever, because I've stated right up front, yes, the name Jesus does work. However, we just read that he's going to return a pure tongue. At Paleo Hebrew. So we know that Jesus is not his Paleo Hebrew name. The name Jesus is reverse translated to mean I am salvation. And we used Yeshua, which morphed into Yeshua, which morphed into Iesus in Latin. And then with the introduction of the letter J, it became Jesus. John 16:11 King James Bible, John chapter 5, verse 43. It is written, I am come in my Father's name, and ye receive me not. If another shall come in his own name, him ye will receive. So I'm going to tell you, and I've debated about this going back and forth. I'm going to tell you what I believe Jesus' Paleo Hebrew name is. But I don't have any proof. I am not a linguist. I could not find it in writing anywhere what the Paleo Hebrew name would be. So I ask that you please study for yourself and allow the Holy Spirit to guide you. With that being said, I believe Jesus's Paleo Hebrew name is Yeshayah. So you see how it incorporates that name, Ahayah? And with that yes in front of it, I don't know what it means in Paleo Hebrew, but it just feels right, because it's the name of the Father is in the name of the Son. The Son came in the Father's name, and we received him not. And I don't know anyone, and I could be wrong, I don't know anyone who walks around with the name Yeshayah. Number four, role reversal. New Living Translation, Isaiah chapter 5, verse 17 and 20. It is written, in that day, the end time reference, lambs will find good pasture, and fattened sheep and young goats will feed among the ruins. What sorrow for those who say that evil is good and good is evil. That dark is light, and light is dark. That bitter is sweet, and sweet is bitter. So I'm going to use that scripture to address the alphabet community. You can read between the lines. God has spoken on gay and pride. And I'm just going to read three scriptures. So I don't appear that I'm judging anyone, because these are not going to be my words. So if you got an issue with what I'm about to read, you take it up with the Most High, Ahayah. New Living Translation, 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verses 9 through 11. It is written, don't you realize that those who do wrong will not inherit the kingdom of God? Don't fool yourselves. Those who indulge in sexual sin, or who worship idols, or commit adultery, or are made prostitutes, or practice homosexuality, or are thieves, or greedy people, or drunkards, or are abusive, or cheat people, none of these will inherit the kingdom of God. Some of you were once like that, but you were cleansed. You were made holy. You were made right with God by calling on the name of the Lord Jesus Christ and by the Spirit of our God. New Living Translation, James chapter 4, verse 6 and 7, it is written, and he gives grace generously. As the scriptures say, God opposes the proud, but gives grace to the humble. So humble yourselves before God. Resist the devil, and he will flee from you. New Living Translation, Ezekiel chapter 16, verse 49 and 50. It is written, Sodom's sin. We know about Sodom and Gomorrah, what they used to do in Sodom and Gomorrah. All that freaky deaky nasty stuff, right? With people of the same sex. So Sodom's sins were pride, gluttony, and laziness, while the poor and needy suffered outside her door. She was proud and committed detestable sins. So I wiped her out, as you have seen. So there you have it, brothers and sisters. Other than my little commental outburst, everything else was the word of the Most High. Please take heed. Number 5, time speeding up. New Living Translation by Matthew chapter 24, verses 21 through and 22. It is written, for there will be greater anguish than at any time since the world began, and it will never be so great again. In fact, unless that time of calamity is shortened, not a single person will survive, but it will be shortened for the sake of God's chosen ones. So how do you shorten something? So if you were watching something that you taped on TV and you get to, and it's an hour long show, but it has commercial breaks in it, how do you shorten that time? You fast forward through the commercials, right? So that could be the way that this time of calamity is shortened. God presses the fast forward button to get us through it quicker. New Living Translation, Amos chapter 9, verse 13 through 15. It is written, the time will come, another end time reference, says the Lord, when the grain and grapes will grow faster than they can be harvested. Then the terraced vineyards on the hills of Israel will drip with sweet wine. Another reference. We haven't gotten there yet, but it's coming. Another reference showing that the time will speed up. Things are changing so rapidly. I don't know about you, brothers and sisters, but my head spins. I have to turn up the TV. I don't even like watching the news anymore because it changes every second. Number 6, the rise of lawlessness. 1611 King James Bible, Genesis chapter 6, verse 11 through 13. It is written, now God saw that the earth had become corrupt and was filled with violence. God observed all this corruption in the world, for everyone on earth was corrupt. So God said to Noah, I have decided to destroy all living creatures, for they have filled the earth with violence. Yes, I will wipe them all out along with the earth. Now, you might be saying, what are you reading that for? That's all, that's ancient history. You think that doesn't apply now, right? Think again. 1611 King James Bible, Luke chapter 17, verse 26. It is written, when the Son of Man returns, it will be like it was in the day, Noah's day. So that directly impacts what's going on right now. Because we are close to his return, brothers and sisters. I don't know when, can't say when or where, but the seasons are all, the signs are all there. They're happening almost every day, another sign. Let's look at this excerpt from Insider Magazine. The headline says, the Facebook, now Meta, exec leading the metaverse mission, reportedly said, VR, or virtual reality, can be toxic, and it will be practically impossible to moderate how people behave. That means those VRs, anything goes. Isn't that the definition of lawlessness? There'll be no accountability in that virtual reality world. You can do and say and be whoever, wherever, do whatever you want. That's lawlessness, brothers and sisters. And you got to remember, Jesus upped the ante. He said, even if you think about a particular sin, you've committed the sin. And this virtual reality world is just promoting that. It's evil. It's demonic. Keep your children away from it as much as possible. Don't not let them get sucked into that universe. And don't you get sucked into it yourself. So that name, that new name, Meta, if you turn it around, those letters, reverse it, and you read this little blurb. You can pause the video and you read it. I'm not going to read all this, but this gives you a little bit of insight into that name. And you might say I'm stretching things a bit, you know, because it's reversed, but you read it and you judge for yourself. I just put that there for you to edify yourself. But I'm going to move on. Number 7. This one may blow many of your minds. Pay attention. The move towards one world religion. 1611 King James Bible, Revelation chapter 13, verses 8 and 12. It is written, and all the people who belong to this world worshiped the beast. They are the ones whose names were not written in the book of life that belongs to the Lamb, who was slaughtered before the world was made. He exercised all the authority of the first beast, and he required all the earth and its people to worship the first beast, whose fatal wound had been healed. How many of you heard of this project called the Abrahamic Family House? Here are a couple of pictures or artist renditions of this project. And you might think it's an abstract, but if you skip down to the bottom, its planned completion date is next year. So this is a reality. This is going on. The Abrahamic Family House is an interfaith complex on Saadiyat Island in Abu Dhabi, inspired by the 2019 document on human fraternity. It houses a synagogue, a mosque, and a church. The Imam Al-Tayeb Mosque, St. Francis or Pope Francis Church, and Moses Ben Maimon Synagogue, respectively. That sounds like one world government, brothers and sisters. One world religion, I should say. It's not no longer a pie in the sky. This is going to be completed next year. We're in, this is December 2nd. Next year will be here in about 28 days, 29 days. Now, it doesn't say what time in 2022, but still, we'll be in 2022 before you know it. Everything is lining up. You got to pay attention. Number 8, true Israel's blindness is ending. 1611 King James Bible, Romans chapter 1, excuse me, chapter 11, verses 1 and 25. It is written, I say then, hath God cast away his people? God forbid, for I also am an Israelite, of the seed of Abraham, of the tribe of Benjamin. This is Paul writing to the Romans. Continues on, for I would not, brethren, that ye should be ignorant of this mystery, lest ye should be wise in your own conceits, that blindness, in part, is happened to Israel until the fullness of the Gentiles be come in. So that's a lot of high old school English talking that probably lost some people. But I got the New Living Translation just for that verse 25. And we're going to read it again. Romans 11, 25, a New Living Translation. It is written, I want you to understand this mystery, dear brothers and sisters, so that you will not feel proud about yourselves. Some of the people of Israel have hard hearts, also known as blindness in the other version, right? But this will last only until the full number of Gentiles comes to Christ. So he has a number in his head of the number of Gentiles that he wants to bring and call into his glorious light. True Israel is starting to wake up. So what is the mystery, though? So you define mystery. Mystery is something that is difficult or impossible to understand or explain. The people of the political state of Israel know who Christ is, but they don't believe that he's the Messiah. So there's no mystery. They know who he is. Where's the mystery? Where's the blindness? What is impossible to explain about that? God dispersed his chosen people, Judah in particular, to the four corners of the earth. Who are they? Now that's a mystery. It was a mystery until the blindness wore off, meaning that the fullness of the Gentiles is near. The 400-year prophecy as told to Abraham is over. Remember, the slavery started 1619. 400 years later is 2019. And that you have to count that last year means it ends in 2020. And we all know what happened in 2020 after that spiritual blindness wore off. All hell broke loose. pandemic fever all over the place. Everybody's in lockdowns and people losing their jobs. People are dying. You think that's a coincidence that the 400-year prophecy is over and then all this stuff starts to happen? You know I don't believe in coincidences, brothers and sisters. It's not a coincidence. Why is all this stuff happening? Because true Israel is waking up. And once again, the Lord is choosing us. He is telling the world, let my people go. If you want to experience the mercy and grace of our King, I suggest you graft in where you fit in. Join the family today. Tomorrow's not promised, brothers and sisters. Get in where you fit in. Come on. Here's a suggested prayer that if you pause this video right now and you recite this prayer with sincerity in your heart, I want to be the first to welcome you to the family. On this channel, though, we don't make orphans. I'm going to give you three simple steps on how to grow in your faith. This is just the beginning of your walk. Number one, read your Bible daily. At least read a chapter a day. And I know many people say they don't know how to read the Bible. It's too confusing. Well, you find yourself a version that is easy for you to read. And in my episode number 62, and I changed the title of it, it's now How to Read the Bible. It will guide you on how you go about reading, what sections to read, and in what order to read them, and why you will read them that way. So it's no longer called You're His Story. It's now How to Read the Bible, but it's still episode number 62 on this channel. Find a Bible based place for you to grow. This place must feed your spirit as well as your mind. The Lord is looking for people to worship Him in spirit and in truth. And if you're not reading this book, you are missing out on the truth. And last but not least is to pray without ceasing. That means to seek the Father in all your comings and goings. Turn the keys over to Him, and He won't steer you wrong. All right, brothers and sisters, remember the cap for Christ at 12:34 Eastern Standard Time, AM and PM. It's all about us speaking with one voice, 12:34 AM and PM. Just simply meditate and just state kumbaya, kumbaya, 60 seconds. That's all it takes. Out loud if you're in private, and if you're not in private, you just say it in your mind, bow your head. 60 seconds of kumbaya, come by God. You can check me out on Facebook, Hebrew Connect, YouTube, and of course now on Rumble. Email address is right in the middle of your screen. You can drop me a line in the comments. Love to hear from you. If this episode has blessed you, give it the thumbs up, but more importantly, share it with others. It's our duty to be gathering those who are lost, calling them into His marvelous light. You can follow us on Facebook, all the other channels. You can simply subscribe. We'd love to have you. Brothers and sisters, love you guys. I appreciate you guys. Thank you for watching. As always, worship the Father, praise the Son, and accept the Holy Spirit. Y'all be blessed. And may our Lord and Savior grant you his peace that surpasses all understanding. May it rest, rule, and abide with you now, henceforth, and forevermore. Amen.